die, you donate the organs to somebody who needs it.
Okay, that's good.
It's about my...
No, that's good, that's good. However, the only way that you become an organ donor is if you're registered. It's the most important. Pre-registered through DMV, if you have on your license, if you have a pink dot that's permanent on your license, you're automatically on the register list. If not, and something happens to you and you pass away, then your family would have to make that decision at the hospital. And it's a decision that they don't want to be making. Because they don't really know how to answer that after they just lost their loved one. So what we do is we register people to become an organ donor. So when that time does come, then you're already on the registry list and all the preservation will be made. We will not take your organs until the day you pass away. So you don't have to worry about us knocking on your door in the middle of the night, saying, hey, give me your kidney. The reason for this event here is the fact that she had received the kidney and she's able to enjoy life a little bit longer than what, you know, could have.
Amen. And the first part of this church actually needs a kidney. And there simply are not enough to go around. So we give these as often as we possibly can to get as many people to register as we possibly can. So by any means necessary, go to the door and get them to sign up.
Somebody loses their life every 18 minutes.
Thank you so much.
Because they are waiting on an organ to be donated.
I said I walked in.
Ranging from the kids up to 60, 70-year-old people. There's just not enough at this time to go around. My wife's mother receives kidneys, and my mother, when she passed, we donated her organs and a 4-year-old boy that will live
after
to see because of it. So if you guys would like to become a donor, we can register you here. It'll take you 2 minutes to do it. If you're already registered, I appreciate your time.
Thank you. Thank you for coming back.